Senate will come to order. Ask all present to please rise and join with me as we recite the Pledge of Allegiance to our flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. In the absence of clergy, I'd ask everyone to please bow their head in a moment of silent prayer. And as we reflect today, let's remember Ecclesiastes chapter 7, verse 8, better is the end of a thing than the beginning thereof. The reading of the journal.
In Senate Tuesday, June 23rd, the Senate met pursuant to adjournment. The journal of Monday, June 22nd, was read.
Without objection, the journal will stand approved as read. Presentation of petitions. I have been asked for some order in the House because we have a number of substitutions, I believe, in messages from the Assembly. The Secretary will read.
On page 7, Senator Young moved to discharge the Committee on Rules, Assembly Bill number 2362, and substitute for the identical Senate Bill 4193, third reading calendar 243. On page 9, Senator Flanagan moved to discharge from the Committee on Rules, Assembly Bill number 7315, and substitute for the identical Senate Bill 4187A, third reading calendar 300. On page 11, Senator Libous moved to discharge from the Committee on Rules, Assembly Bill number 796, and substituted for the identical Senate Bill 2931, third reading calendar 407. On page 18, Senator Martins moved to discharge from the Committee on Rules, Assembly Bill number 3390A, and substituted for the identical Senate Bill 4402A, third reading calendar 682. On page 19, Senator Carlucci moved to discharge from the Committee on Rules, Assembly Bill number 2122A, and substituted for the identical Senate Bill 4266A, third reading calendar 723. On page 19, Senator Hanna moved to discharge from the Committee on Rules, Assembly Bill number 7427A, and substituted for the identical Senate Bill 5170A, third reading calendar 825. On page 21, Senator Latimer moved to discharge from the Committee on Rules, Assembly Bill number 2761B, and substitute for the identical Senate Bill 4166C, third reading calendar 1001. On page 21, Senator Gallivan moved to discharge the Committee on Rules, Assembly Bill number 2458A, and substitute for the identical Senate Bill 71A, third reading calendar 1011. On page 22, Senator Flanagan moved to discharge the Committee on Rules, Assembly Bill number 3057A, and substitute for the identical Senate Bill 2696A, third reading calendar 1032. On page 24, Senator Amador moved to discharge from Committee on Rules, Assembly Bill number 7753, and substitute for the identical Senate Bill 4975, third reading calendar 1109. On page 27, Senator Kennedy moved to discharge from Committee on Judiciary, Assembly Bill number 2026, and substitute for the identical Senate Bill 2152, third reading calendar 1226. On page 27, Senator Bonasek moved to discharge from the Committee on Rules, Assembly Bill number 7645, and substitute identical Senate Bill 5678, third reading calendar 1228. On page 27, Senator Marchione moved to discharge from the Committee on Finance, Assembly Bill number 2778, and substitute the identical Senate Bill 1081, third reading calendar 1257. On page 32, Senator Gallivan moved to discharge the Committee on Rules, Assembly Bill number 8177B, and substitute the identical Senate Bill number 5854B, third reading calendar 1728. And on page 32, Senator Lanza moved to discharge from the Committee on Rules, Assembly Bill number 5317B, and substitute the identical Senate Bill 5893B, third reading calendar 1743.
Substitutions are so ordered as read and presented. Messages from the Governor. Reports of standing committees. Reports of select committees. Communications and reports of state officers. Motions and resolutions. Senator DeFrancisco.
An observation.
Yes.
Whether the end of the thing is better than the beginning of the thing depends upon what the thing is. And that's from DeFrancisco verses 1 through 5. Back to motions and resolutions. I wish to call Senator Venditto's bill at the desk, Senate print number 3822, recalled from the assembly, which is now at the desk.
Secretary will read.
Calendar number 231 by Senator Venditto, Senate Print 3822, enact amend the criminal procedure law.
I now move to reconsider the vote by which the bill was passed.
Call the roll on reconsideration.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Klein, Libous, Stewart, Cousins, Young, ayes 60.
I now offer the following amendments.
Amendments are received.
Also, at this time, I'd like to hand up some committee assignments.
Committee assignments are received, and they should be filed in a journal.
All right, now if we could please go to the non-controversial reading of active list for today.
Okay, the secretary will read the non-controversial reading of today's active list.
Calendar number 243 by a member of the Assembly, Brindisi, Assembly Print 2362, enact amend the executive law.
Last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Klein, Libous, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Can we raise your hands again if you're in a negative? Calendar number 243. Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 243, those recorded in the negative are Senators Martins, Penapinto, and Ranzenhofer. Ayes 57, nays 3.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 300 by member of the Assembly Thiel, Assembly Print 7315, enact amend the vehicle and traffic law.
Read the last section.
Section 5, this act should take effect on the 1st of November.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Klein, Libous, Stewart, Cousins, Young. Ayes 59, nays 1. Senator Ranzenhofer recorded in the negative.
Bill's passed.
Calendar number 407 by member of Assembly Braunstein, Assembly Print 796, enact amend the state finance law.
Read the last section.
Section 4, this act should take effect on the 30th day.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Klein, Libous, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Those in the negative, please raise your hand. Secretary will announce the results. Senator Gennaris?
Okay.
Why do you rise?
Never mind, Mr.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.
I hope you stretched well. Secretary will announce the results.
Relation to calendar 407, those recorded in the negative for Senators Avella, Breslin, Carlucci, Comrie, Diaz, Dillon, Espaillat, Gianaris, Hamilton, Hassel-Thompson, Hoylman, Kennedy, Klein, Krueger, Latimer, Montgomery, Penapinto, Parker, Peralta, Perkins, Rivera, Sanders, Savino, Serrano, Squadron, Stavisky, Stewart, Cousins, and Valesky. Ayes 32, nays 28.
The bill's passed.
Calendar number 606 by Senator O'Meara, Senate Print 1151, enacted amendment to general municipal law.
Read the last section.
Section 3 of this act should take effect on the 120th day.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Klein, Libous, Stewart, Cousins, Young. Ayes 60.
The bill is passed.
Ayes 60.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 635 by Senator Golden, Senate Print 50.
Bill will be laid aside temporarily.
Calendar number 682 by Member of the Assembly Tatone, Assembly Print 3398, enacted amendment to workers' compensation law.
Secretary, I'll read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Klein, Libous, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Announce the results.
Relation to calendar 682, those recorded the negative are Senators Breslin, Comrie, Diaz, Dillon, Espaillat, Gianaris, Hoylman, Latimer, Parker, Peralta, Perkins, Rivera, Sanders, Serrano, Squadron, and Stavisky. Ayes 44, nays 16.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 723 by Member of Assembly Jaffe, Assembly Print 2122A. Enacting related to transfer.
Read the last section.
Section 2 of this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Klein, Libous, Stewart, Cousins, Young. Ayes 60.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 825 by Member of Assembly Kuzik, Assembly Print 7427A. Enacting amend the public health law.
Read the lay it aside.
Calendar number 826 by Senator Hamilton, Senator Hannon. Senate Print 5313, enact amend the public health law.
Read the last section.
Section 5, this act should take effect on the 180th day.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Klein, Libous, Stewart, Cousins, Young. Ayes 59, nays 1, Senator Felder recorded in the negative.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 948 by Senator Golden, Senate Print 4072, enact amend the penal law.
Last section.
Section 40, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Klein, Libous, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Results.
Ayes 58, nays 2, Senators Montgomery and Perkins recorded in the negative.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 1001 by Member of Assembly Mayor, Assembly Print 2761B, enact amend the penal law.
Last section.
Section 2 of this act should take effect on the 1st of November.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Klein, Libous, Stewart, Cousins, Young. Ayes 59, nays 1, Senator Perkins recorded in the negative.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 1011 by Member of Assembly Bronson, Assembly Print 2458A, And Act to amend the public service law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Klein, Libous, Stewart, Cousins, Young. Ayes 60.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 1032 by Member of Assembly Morelli, Assembly Print 3057A, an act amend the general business law.
Last section.
Section 2, this act take effect January 1, 2017.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Klein, Libous, Stewart, Cousins, Young. Ayes 60.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 1109 by Member of Assembly Morelli, Assembly Print 7753, an act amend the labor law.
Last section.
Section 4, this act shall take effect on the 1st of January.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Klein, Libous, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Results.
Relation to calendar 1109, those recorded the negative are Senators Comrie, DeLon, Espaillat, Gianaris, Hamilton, Hoylman, Kennedy, Krueger, Montgomery, Panapinto, Parker, Peralta, Perkins, Rivera, Sanders, Serrano, Squadron, and Stavisky.
You're up. In a negative, please raise your hands. Secretary will re-announce.
Those recorded in the negative are Senators Comrie, DeLon, Espaillat, Gianaris, Hamilton, Hoylman, Kennedy, Krueger, Montgomery, Panapinto, Parker, Peralta, Perkins, Rivera, Sanders, Serrano, Squadron, and Stavisky. Ayes 42, nays 18.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 1111 by Senator Martin, Senate Print 5274, an act amend the labor law.
Read the last section.
Section 5, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Klein, Libous, Stewart, Cousins, Young. Ayes 60.
Bill is passed. Announce results again.
Relation to calendar 1111. Ayes 59, nays 1. Senator Peralta recorded the negative.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 1226 by Member of Assembly Ryan, Assembly Print 2026, an act amend the general obligations law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Klein, Libous, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Senator Kennedy to explain his vote.
Thank you, Mr. President. I rise today on this important piece of legislation that will help provide greater financial security to the families who have lost loved ones to vicious acts of terror. These families have already suffered the ultimate heartbreak at the hands of callous extremists. And when it boils down to it, no financial settlement can ever equate to the pain that they've suffered. But we need to do our part to make sure that they're receiving what's rightfully theirs, and help to give them some sense of comfort in their time of grief. So many Americans search for ways to help after witnessing terrorist attacks on our nation, and it's our responsibility to make sure we're doing everything we can to facilitate that aid. With this bill, annuity insurers can structure settlements granted to families of victims of terrorist attacks and do so pro bono if they choose, providing a greater payout to these families. Currently, they're not able to do so under state law, and they may risk losing their licenses if they do so. We've already granted this type of waiver to families of the victims of 9/11. But sadly, there's many more cases when this kind of waiver could be useful. Cases like the Boston Marathon bombings, the 1993 World Trade Center bombing, or the story that's made headlines lately in Washington, the Beirut bombing of 1983. While the families of the 241 Americans who were killed in the bombing of a Marine Corps barracks in Lebanon wait for the U.S. Supreme Court decision on a potential $1.75 billion settlement from the Bank of Iran, I'm proud that the New York State Senate is doing our part to ensure that these families get every single penny that they rightfully deserve. There are several of our colleagues whose input and support was essential in this process. I'd like to thank Senator Bonasek, Senator Nozzolio, Senator Gallivan, Senator Klein, Senator Flanagan, and of course my leader, Senator Andrea Stewart Cousins, for their help in bringing this important bill to the floor today. And I'm confident Governor Cuomo will swiftly sign this bill into law to help these grieving families. Thank you, Mr. President. I vote aye.
Senator Kennedy to be recorded in the affirmative. Senator Croce to explain his vote.
President, I do want to compliment my colleague, the sponsor, for this important legislation. And it is very important that we take care of the families who have been victims in the terrorist attacks on the United States. But it should not in any way abrogate our responsibilities as the upper house of this state to do everything we can, and in some cases to lead the executive branch and the lower house of this state to take every possible step to prevent a terrorist attack so that other families will not have to endure the hardships and the tragedies that we have seen in all of the terrorist attacks on the United States. We have an opportunity to take those steps now as elected, not only elected officials in this body, but elected leaders of our communities. Our most profound responsibility is the protection of our communities. No community, no state was more deeply wounded on September 11, 2001 than the communities of New York. And so we have an even greater responsibility to do so. I compliment my colleague on this important piece of legislation, and I look forward to even greater efforts to make sure that we prevent the kind of attacks that have so deeply wounded our nation. Thank you.
Senator Croce to be recorded in the affirmative. Announce the results.
Aye, 60.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 1228 by Member of the Assembly Weinstein, Assembly Print 7645, an act to amend the domestic relations law.
Read the last section.
Section 8, this act should take effect on the 120th day.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Klein, Libous, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Senator Bonasek to explain his vote.
Did he call my name?
Yeah.
Senator Bonasek to explain his vote.
Thank you, Mr. President. This is a very important and significant piece of legislation. Back in 2010, when Senator Ruth Hassel Thompson was chairwoman of judiciary, the no-fault divorce law was passed in the state of New York. We were the last state to do it. And at the time, we realized, as members of the Judiciary Committee, that we had to revisit the cap of which the parties would have to pay spousal maintenance, both before a divorce and after a divorce. So what happened was that there were about 3 years of matrimonial experience, what was going on in the courts. And the Law Revision Commission, back in 2013, issued a report and said something has to be done because the courts were getting congested with matrimonial actions because the cap was so high. And when I say the cap was so high is that there was 19 considerations where a judge could determine how much support traditionally the breadwinner, the man, would pay the wife. And because of that big spread, many lawyers both were skeptical whether they're representing the man or the woman, did not come to court too quickly because they didn't know what to expect. In 2014, Senator Thompson and I had legislative hearings, and we asked all the stakeholders in the state of New York that worked on matrimonials. The Bar Association, the Women's Bar, the judges, all the women's groups. We heard testimony. And finally, as a result of that consensus that came from all of the stakeholders, from the bottom up to us, there was an agreement by all of the parties, except the magistrates. And I didn't count that too much because the magistrates are not a court of record. So from now on, through family court, Supreme Court, no matter what court you choose to go in, when you're talking about spousal maintenance, nothing to do with child support, before a divorce and after a divorce, there's going to be guidelines, stricter guidelines. The cap has been reduced to $175,000. So wherever the payor, let's say for the most part the husband, could be the wife, but let's say it's the husband, is making $175,000 or less, there is a formula in place that will bring clarity and predictability to the amount of spousal support. And that was extremely important. It will take care of 94% of all the divorce actions that come before our judges. And again, I want to single out Ruth Hassel Thompson, who was always committed to working on this issue from when we started to where we are today. Now, those actions above the payor, above $175,000, 6% of the actions, that will be still subject to 19 considerations where a judge will make determinations. Durability of the marriage, earning capacity, the health of each spouse, and I can go on and on and on. But there, a judge would use his discretion above the cap. So this is monumental. We thought this affects many people's lives. The Judge Sunshine, who brought all the matchup groups together, was a strong factor in bringing consensus, and we congratulate him for that. And the other thing I may add, when one gets divorced, spousal maintenance or alimony, as we know it, ends. That's not the case today under current law, but it will be once this passes. It's already passed the Assembly. It will pass today. And I thank all my colleagues for their support. It was a long journey to get here from 2010. Thank you, Mr. President. I vote aye.
Senator Bosack to be recorded in the affirmative. Senator Hassel Thompson to explain her vote.
Thank you, Mr. President. There's very little left to say. Thank you, Senator Bonasack, except that I want to thank you for not only the work that you conscientiously put into this, but for continuing to allow me to share in the passage of this legislation and to participate in every way fully, even though I am in the minority. I think it's very rare that that happens in this chamber. I wish it happened more, but I have a great appreciation and respect for you, and particularly more so since the work that you allowed me to continue to, you know, my input into this bill. The other thing is that I want to thank all of our colleagues that signed on and were patient while this was being negotiated. There were a lot of people who didn't think that this was going to happen. They were very disappointed because they thought that we would never get a good maintenance bill. But I think that, as you have explained, all of the people who have a vested interest in this came together finally and put all their differences in the pot and came out with something that I think that all of us can now live with. So I'm very proud of the legislation that we did, and particularly because of the people who will be most adversely affected were it not so. And again, Mr. President, I want to thank you. You know, through you, Mr. President, I want to thank Senator Bonasack for his support of me throughout this entire process.
Senator Hassel Thompson to be recorded in the affirmative. Announce the results.
Aye, 60.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 1257 by Member of Assembly McDonald, Assembly Print 2778, enact amend the agriculture markets law.
Last section.
Section 2 of this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Klein, Libous, Stewart, Cousins, Jung. No.
Senator Marchione to explain her vote.
I just would like to talk about this bill a little bit. You know, the purpose of it is that it authorizes up to 20% of the New York State Animal Population Control Fund to be used for trapping, neutering, spaying, and releasing feral cats. It does not mandate that municipalities or entities have to embark upon a TNR program. It doesn't state that if municipalities or entities have a different way of handling feral cats, that they can't continue to do that. It simply allows 20%, up to 20% of this fund to be able to be used for TNR, which in my mind is a proven way of handling feral cats. Here are some statistics. In Buffalo, TNR reduced a feral cat population at Ralph Williams Stadium by 90%. In Syracuse, TNR reduced a feral cat population by almost 35%. In New York City, the euthanasia rate was 32,000 in 2003. With TNR over this time period, in 2013, the euthanasia rate dropped to 6,000. There has been a 30% decline in population across the city's 2,000 feral cat colonies since TNR was implemented in each. TNR programs have been operating in New York State for over 30 years. This simply allows the administrator of the New York State Animal Population Control Fund, the ASPCA, to offer another program to handle this concern. You know, in my district, the reason that I even became a sponsor of this bill is I had some farmers who would tell me they used to try to take the cats and have them spayed and then return them. And it's just getting too expensive for them. And that's the method that they would prefer to use. So, Mr. President, for all of those reasons, I vote aye.
Senator Marchione to be recorded in the affirmative. Senator Hoylman to explain his vote.
I rise to support the Senator's bill and want to thank her for her leadership and those compelling statistics on how the trap and neuter and release program actually reduces the number of feral cats. I did want to raise a couple of concerns about the bill, which have to do with endangered birds. In particular, one bird which is evocative of the problem. It's called the Piper Plover. And there are only about 200 of them left, and they live on sandy beaches in Long Island and Queens. And the problem with the way they inhabit these beaches is that they nest on shells and are very vulnerable to feral cats attacking them. And we need to, at the same time, Mr. President, as we move forward with this legislation that will humanely reduce the feral cat population, look at ways that we can provide more money in protecting birds and other endangered species from feral cats. So I'll be voting in the positive and thank again the Senator for her leadership. Thank
Senator
you,
Senator Hoylman to be recorded in the affirmative. Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 1257, those recorded in the negative are Senators Avella, Bonasek, Carlucci, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Griffo, Little, Marcelino, Seward, and Valesky. Also, Senator Funke. Ayes 49, nays 11.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 1289 by Senator Amador, Senate Print 5315A, an act authorized.
Read the last section.
Section 9.
Lay it aside for the day.
Calendar number 1728 by Member of Assembly DePietro, Assembly Print 8177B, an act amend the highway law.
Last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Klein, Libous, Stewart, Cousins, Jung.
Results.
Aye, 60.
Bill's passed.
Calendar number 1729 by Senator Marchione, Senate Print 5857A, an act authorized.
Last section.
Section 2 of this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Klein, Libous, Stewart, Cousins, Young. Ayes 58, nays 2, Senators Bonasek and Larkin, recorded in the negative.
Bill's passed.
Calendar number 1743 by Member of the Assembly Braunstein, Assembly Print 5317B, an act amending the general business law.
Last section.
Section 2 of this act should take effect on the 180th day.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Klein, Libous, Stewart, Cousins, Young. Ayes 59, nays 1, Senator Seward, recorded in the negative.
Bill's passed.
Calendar number 1849 by Senator Robach, Senate Print 5987, an act amending chapter of the laws of 2015.
Read the last section.
Section 2 of this act should take effect on the same date in the same manner as chapter of the laws of 2015.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Klein, Libous, Stewart, Cousins, Young. Ayes 60.
Bill's passed.
Calendar number 1871 by the Senate Committee on Rules, Senate Print 5963, an act amending the executive law.
Lay it aside. Senator DeFrancisco, that completes the non-controversial reading of today's active list calendar.
Yes, can we now go to the non-controversial reading and take up calendar 825 by Senator Hannon?
We will continue non-controversial for, did you say non-controversial, correct?
No. Controversial.
Okay, we're going to go to the controversial calendar. The secretary will ring the bell. And the secretary will read calendar number 825 by Senator Hannon.
Calendar number 825 by Member of the Assembly Kuzik, Assembly Print 7427A, an act amending the public health law.
Read the last section.
Section 3 of this act should take effect on the 120th day.
Debate is closed. Seeing no senator that wishes to be heard, last section has been read. Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Klein, Libous, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Bell has been rung. Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Klein, Libous, Stewart, Cousins, Young. Relation to calendar 825, those recorded in the negative are Senators Diaz and Seward. Absent from voting, Senator Sampson. Ayes 58, nays 2.
The bill is passed, and that completes the controversial reading of calendar number 825, Senator DeFrancisco.
Thank you. I would like to now call for an immediate meeting of the Investigations and Government Operations Committee, followed by the Finance Committee, which I'll announce at the time the Investigations Committee is done, and that meeting will be in room 332. Until both meetings are done, we'll be at ease.
There will be an immediate meeting of the Senate Committee on Government Operations and Investigations in room 332. An immediate meeting of the Senate Committee on Government Operations and Investigations in room 332. That will be followed by a committee meeting of the Senate Committee on Finance, also room 332, which will be called upon completion of the meeting of Government Operations and Investigations. Senate will stand at ease. Senate will come to order.
Do we have a report from the Investigations Committee?
No.
It's my understanding that you have a report from the Finance Committee at the desk.
There is a report of the Finance Committee at the desk. The Secretary will read.
Senator DeFrancisco from the Committee on Finance reports the following nominations. As Commissioner and Chairman of the State Liquor Authority, Vincent Bradley, Jr. of Kingston.
I move the nomination.
Nomination has been moved. All in favor of Vincent Bradley as Chairman and Commissioner of the State Liquor Authority signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed. Vincent Bradley Jr. has been confirmed as Chairman and Commissioner of the New York State Liquor Authority. Congratulations, Mr. Bradley, and good luck. Secretary will read.
As Chairman and Chief Executive Officer of the Metropolitan Transportation Authority, Thomas Prendergast of Brewster.
Before moving the nomination, I want to apologize to the two nominees that are appearing. Everyone is moving today as fast as we can to get through these last days of session, hopefully last day of session. So we apologize that we didn't have a lot of fine words, but for both of you, you definitely were clearly well qualified and unanimously went through all the committees, and we appreciate you're being willing to serve. Great nominations by the governor. With that said, I now move the nomination of Mr. Prendergast.
Senator Robach.
Yes, very graciously, Mr. President. Let me rise to support this nomination. He has a record that obviously speaks for himself. He's been doing that job. And it is a big system for anyone who's ever ridden it, between the subway, the buses, and everything. I believe the number is they move a quarter, or three quarters, excuse me, of the people move by train in our whole nation are done by the MTA, and that in itself is a monumental job, but they really keep one of the most vibrant cities in our state, in our nation, moving, and he's done that very, very well. And I would just say, in addition to reaching out to all the members and being accessible, not only at state government, but local government, I would just say, under Mr. Prendergast's leadership, I also greatly, greatly appreciate the integrated system and trying to use New York vendors for everything associated with transportation when humanly possible, amplifying those transportation dollars. So very happy to support this nomination and look forward to working with Mr. Prendergast and the entire MTA. Thank you.
Senator Gianaris.
The MTA is a difficult agency to lead and not a very popular one with many residents. It's a thankless job, but Tom Pendergast has been doing a terrific job, not only running a difficult agency, but reaching out to communities and elected representatives to make sure that the input of local residents is a vital part of what he does. And so I wanted to thank him for that and congratulate him and support his nomination as well. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator Gennaro. Senator Murphy.
I just rise to congratulate my constituent, Mr. Pendergast, and we wish you the best and congratulations.
Question is on the nomination of Thomas F. Pendergast as Chairman and Chief Executive Officer of Metropolitan Transportation Authority. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed. Thomas F. Pendergast is confirmed as Chairman and Chief Executive Officer of the Metropolitan Transportation Authority. Mr. Pendergast, congratulations and best of luck. Secretary will continue.
As members of the Port Authority of New York and New Jersey, Stephen M. Cohen of Brooklyn, Hamilton E. James of New York, and Michael D. Feschitelli of New York.
Move the nominations.
Question is on the nominations of Stephen M. Cohen and Hamilton E. James and Michael D. Feschitelli. All in favor, as members of the Port Authority of New York, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed. Stephen Cohen, Hamilton James, and Michael Feschitelli are hereby confirmed as members of the Port Authority of New York and New Jersey. The Secretary will continue.
As member of the Continuing Care Retirement Community Council, Carol A. Fenter of South Setauket.
Move the nomination.
Question is on Carol A. Fenter as a member of the Continuing Care Retirement Community Council. All in favor signify by saying aye. Opposed. Carol A. Fenter is hereby confirmed as a member of the Continuing Care Retirement Community Council. Secretary will continue.
As Commissioner of the State Civil Service Commission, Janique Green of Yonkers.
Move the nomination.
Question is on Janique Green as a member of the State Civil Service Commission. All in favor signify by saying aye. Opposed. Janique Green has been confirmed as a member of the New York State Civil Service Commission. Senator DeFrancisco, that completes the nominations before the desk.
Thank you. I believe there's a resolution by you, resolution number 2666. I'd like to move that resolution.
Secretary will read.
Legislative resolution number 2666 by Senator Griffo, reaffirming the commitment to strengthen the ties between the state of New York and the People's Republic of China and welcoming Mr. Xi Jinping, President of the People's Republic of China, to the United States.
All in favor of the resolution signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? The resolution is adopted. Senator DeFrancisco?
Can we now lay aside calendars 635 and 1871 for the day?
The two calendar numbers as identified and listed will be laid aside for the day.
Is there any further business at the desk?
There is no further business at the desk.
There being none, we are adjourned until June 25 at 11 a.m.
On motion, the Senate will stand adjourned until Thursday, June 25th at 11 a.m. The Senate stands adjourned.